It's just lunchtime, but it already looks like rush hour. This is not a parking lot. This is EDSA's infamous heavy traffic. For commuters, it's horrendous and beyond belief.
Masyadong maraming car na nag-exist dito sa Metro Manila.
Yung ano ng mga bus po, medyo mahirap mag-abang.
Transport agencies and commuter groups admit this is already a crisis. So they're holding an emergency traffic summit for 2 days. They say this is not your ordinary gathering.
Tigilin natin yung kakakwentuhan at daldalan. We want a blueprint. Ano ba talaga ang gustong mangyari? Ano talaga ang naihanda ng ating pamahalaan? Ano yung long term na nung papalang 2010 ay mayroon ng programa?
They'll present and debate solutions on how to address Metro Manila's traffic crisis. One of these is the granting of emergency powers to the president.
Sa aming commuters, sa aming damdamin, sa aming nararanasan sa araw-araw, nandoon kami sa puntong nais na namin ito mapatupad.
Groups will also discuss how to improve the no-contact apprehension scheme, as this has only been effective in areas with CCTV cameras. They'll also talk about improving the number coding scheme and placing body cameras on enforcers. The MMDA meanwhile says current policies meant to decongest EDSA will continue. And they'll be adding more zipper lanes along EDSA and other major avenues. Chairman Tim Orbos, however, admits they don't have enough enforcers. The MMDA has only 2,000 enforcers and they need 10,000 more.
Kukunti lang ho kami. Kung mas bigyan ako ng mas madaming tao, gagawin ko po lahat yan.
The groups will submit their consolidated solutions to the Congress and the President. They hope their proposals become the basis for traffic-related laws. Rex Remitio, CNN Philippines.